The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Mr. Excel Excel, a book with 40 Excel tips, plus Excel cartoons, cocktails, tweets, and jokes. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1980, Faster AutoSum. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, before we can move on in the book, we need to build a quick little report here. And so I'm just going to start from scratch on a blank worksheet. And across the top, I want to have week numbers. So any word followed by a space and a number is something that the fill handle will work with. So I'm going to put week one through week five at the top. And then down the left-hand side, back from episode 1978, we created a custom list that will work with the fill handle. So we'll put that down the side. All right, and then I have to type in some numbers, but I don't want to bore you by typing a number. So the fast way to make fake data is a great function called RANDBETWEEN. RANDBETWEEN. I am a huge user of RANDBETWEEN because I'm always creating fake data sets in my live Power Excel seminars. So RANDBETWEEN 10,000 to 20,000 going to give us random numbers. Now this is great for me because I'm creating fake data. I don't know of many uses in real life. I mean, I know. Hey, look, it's tempting. Next year's budget process. Really fast with RANDBETWEEN, but I don't recommend that at all. All right, so there are numbers I'm going to copy and paste as values. All right, so now if we're going to give this report to our manager would say, well, this is great, but can you give me totals? Totals on the right-hand side and totals at the bottom, all right? So normally, the first formula that anyone creates is you come here, you either hit Alt equals or the auto sum, and it proposes a formula. You would accept that formula and copy it across. Also, up here, same thing, auto sum will add across, accept that formula, and copy it down. But there's a much, much faster way to go. I don't know who was crazy enough to try this the first time, but it's a beautiful trick. Select all of your numbers, plus one extra row, plus one extra column, like that, and then either Alt equals or the auto sum, and bam, they had the totals all the way around the right-hand side. Now, I don't know why it is, but if I'm in a room full of accountants, there's always someone who wants to know that corner cell G11, is it adding down or is it adding across? And I always say, it doesn't matter, does it? It should be the same either way. But it is adding across. Ran into one guy who always adds across and adds down and then has a little test to make sure that they're equal. All right, whatever. Okay, now we have to do a little bit of formatting here. First off, I despise the comma style. This comma right here, the comma that's easy for us to use, it adds decimal places. It does weird things when there's zeros, so I'm going to Control Z and undo that. There's nothing in this dropdown that gives me the comma style that I want. I find that I always have to go into Format Cells, and the fast way to do this, you see these little arrows here? These are called dialog launchers. I call it Take Me Back to the Old Way. Of course, we can press Control 1 to get here as well, but that dialog launcher takes us to the Number tab. I go Number, Thousand Separator, Zero Decimal Places, click OK. Like that. That's the comma style that I wish was here. All right, now a little bit more formatting we're going to do just to make it look a little bit better. I'm going to choose the title, go to cell styles. Just outside the view here is something called title, and then I'm going to choose all of my headings and go to cell styles and choose heading 4. There are a lot of cell styles in here, and I don't know why. They think the check cells should be in gray and output cells should be in that gray. I mean, I hate all of these except for heading 4 and title are the two that I use over and over and over again. In fact, you know, wouldn't it be cool if we could take this comma style and add it to the cell styles? Well, you can. So I'm going to choose one cell that has that. Say I'm going to create a new cell style. I'm going to call it comma good. And turn off everything except for the number style. Click OK. All right, so now on a larger screen, I would actually be able to see comma good. It'd be right there in the visible part of the cell styles because you get to see the first 4. Now that's beautiful, except the problem that I have is it only works in this workbook. All right, next week, when we get to page 20 of the book, I'm going to show you how to make that comma style, comma good, be part of all future workbooks that you create. Can't wait till we get to that point. Hang on for that. All right, and then finally, just right justify our headings here, and it looks good. We are good to go. Now, tomorrow's episode, we'll pick up with this report, and I'll show you a lot of cool tricks. Today though, let's just take a quick episode recap. We used the fill handle with any word and a number, the fill handle with a custom list from 1978, episode 1978, using RANDBETWEEN for fake data, but not your budgets. AutoSum around by choosing the data plus the total row in a column, then hitting Alt equals. We used the heading 4 style and the title style. Talked about the number tab up here, that comma style. I hate it. Showed you how to use the dialog launcher, and then created a comma good as a new style, but it won't be until we get to next week's episodes that I'm adding that comma style to all future workbooks. Hey, if you're liking these books, there are many, many more tips like these, and many more that you can get by the book. Click that I in the top right hand corner. Thanks to Bob Umlis for the auto sum trick. He wrote that in one of his Excel Outside the Box books. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.